Hello Gundam fans, this is Brown92, and today I'll be looking at the 1-100 Master Grade Altron Gundam from Gundam Wing. And this is a third-party kit. It's from Supernova, and I did get this from Gundam Central. And I would like to thank both Supernova and Gundam Central for giving me this test sample to review before it comes out. As of this recording, it is up for pre-order, but it's not yet released. And I think this is Supernova's first attempt, I believe. Once again, like almost every other kit I've reviewed that's third party, it is a, I'm fairly confident, a resin conversion using the inner frame of the Shenlong, mostly. But I can tell that it has been extended, because if you notice, the armor is the same as the Shenlong. It has been modified. It is nicely detailed with panel lining, some extra greebling on the armor here and there. But these gaps, basically the inner frame on the legs and on the arms, I believe, and also in the waist, have been extended from the original. So you have these gaps, which I guess is what the original, like the resin was going for. Don't know how I feel about it. It's not terrible, but it is a little distracting. Feet are longer. The chest here is definitely different. We got these cool, like these little kind of like claws on the top here. The head is very different. The neck is very long. Don't really understand that. And the chin is actually long too. I think that's the way the Altron was though. It had the longer chin with segments, I think. The clear green is for the eyes and goes to the forehead and also all the way to the back. Got some extra detail in the thrusters, which are very sharp. Pretty much anything that looks pointy here is pointy, and it hurts. The skirt armor's got a lot more segments in it. It's two-tone green, which I like. You also got some parts that come off the skirt armor here. Not the inner frame part, but the armor likes to come off easily. So do these horns on the head. They're not the most secure. The knee joints are a little loose. They're not terrible. They don't, it doesn't fall over too much, but it is loose, and I like. I also don't understand why this part, it's lower. I guess because the waist has been extended, and so there's a gap here in which they had extended the green here, so I would cover that. Also, something that a lot of third-party kits like to do nowadays, you get the cockpit that opens, but no pilot. So I guess if you omit the pilot that goes with the model, it's okay. I don't get that. Shoulder armor's buried everywhere. You got this part that is supposed to be open. Extra green detailing in there. More panel lining. The arms also have the separation, just a little bit. And all in all, it looks pretty good. Although because of the extension and the length, it does have very long legs compared to the body, I feel. But I think once you see it with the dragon fangs, you'll think that. At least I don't think that once they're attached. It definitely compensates for the long legs. Now, if you watch the unboxing, you'll know that he had a huge sticker sheet, which I haven't used at all. But it is ginormous. That basically gives him a third color of green, pewter gray to go on the white probably, gunmetal. But I don't think it needs it. Like, I don't really like, and I'm sure they try, but I doubt that these stickers are very adhesive. And that's a lot of stickers. If you want to decide to paint it, that's a lot of adhesive you probably have to get off the armor. But the fact that it has two-tone as it is, I think is fine. It looks good. But you do have water slide decals, which are always a nice bonus. So I'm glad we get these. And then there's also a little teeny bit, I'm assuming just detailing, little teeny, not quite, like wedges, I guess. Because. So, all in all, I do really like the actual armor. I love the added panel lining. God, I wish the head wasn't so long. Shenlong. Yeah. You can definitely tell right there, like, that's a kind of a giraffe neck. Don't really like that. But all in all, I think it's pretty good. Now, articulation-wise, pretty much the same as the Shenlong. You got the ball-jointed head, and the hinge neck, which is kind of loose, but it does go pretty far. You have the rotation of the shoulder. It can go out and go up some, although sometimes the arm comes out of the joint. The shoulder armor is a little separate. It can go out, rotate below the shoulder, double joint to double. Doesn't really bend as much as I'd like. I think it's because the armor That's as far as the armor will go at the top here, so it kind of, I think, limits. Because I don't think it should be that high up, I don't think. You got a ball jointed wrist. You got a hinged thumb. And the swappable fingers. But you do get quite a few. These are the holding ones with a little gap to hold the trident. But you got some open hands, some weird, like, martial art hands. Some other holding hands, and closed fists. So, quite a few options. I can't remember if I could have... I have the master right here, but anyways, there's no waist articulation, really. It's a little bit of a bend, but it's really minor. You do have a ball joint, which is very stiff on mine, thankfully. It's really good. You have a ball joint and hinge front skirts. And then you have the hinge side skirts, which I said do like to come apart, so I don't like to move them too much. And you have the ball joint and back skirts, which don't move, really. The legs, if you get the armor out of the way, you can go that far forward, and that far back, that far out, pretty far. So you can rotate the thigh. Nice double-jointed knee, I do like that, think of that. And you have a ball joint in the ankle arm at the top, and also at the bottom. Yeah, that happens. Mostly because it's kind of tight in the, where it goes together, and it doesn't super line up, I feel. Like, there's always a little bit of a gap in there. It's not terrible. And you have the toe hinge. And that is pretty much it. So it is as articulate as the original, I'd say. Not much problems there. So that's alright. Now, weaponry-wise, well, this is where it gets interesting. First off, you do have the shield, which is also nicely detailed, more than the original. It's got the two-tone green, got the gold, and all you have to do is peg it into the arm. Like that. It is pretty secure. I don't have any problem with it falling. Stand up, and then we have... Now, this is the normal trident that we're all used to. This is the double trident. Clear green effect part. Surprisingly, they all have this, I never really noticed until recently, but these holding hands are actually pretty good at holding them. There's a little bit of an indent, which does keep them held. It's a little wobbly, but you have to kind of find the sweet spot in there, and it used to, now that I'm recording, there we go. There's that sweet spot. It's not super easy, like, it's not super hard to knock it off, but it does hold rather well. So yeah, see there, it took that many hits. And you have... give it to me. You have the peg and the handle because you have the cover here, which you can take off. And then replace it. Oop, well, there goes that piece. Ugh. And replace it with the mounting clip. For the trident. And just peg it in. Like so. It is pretty solid. So I like that, but Supernova gives you an extra set. And I actually like this one a hell of a lot better. A physical trident, and that thing is very cool. Was it something the movie Aquaman would use? I think. Yeah, it's very cool, very physical. And yes, every part of here is sharp as hell. Trying to get these extra silver pieces together, it hurt. It hurt a lot. I'll show you. There. It is sharp. It is very, very sharp. So, yeah. To be careful, it holds exactly the same. It's the same trident handle, so it works the same, so you have one stored on the back. Oh yeah, see on. Whatever. You have it stored on the back, and have the other one in the hand. But yeah, two sets. I really like that. Yeah, this is definitely my preferred one instead of the beam one. Beam one's cool. We're used to the beam one, but I like that one. Now you also get the normal stand character for the crotch, but you get this extra one. Which is meant for the backpack, which I can't get to stay on. I feel it's supposed to, like, clip around here. Like, on the backpack, that's what it shows. But I can never get, like, it's too easy to come off. I don't think it would support the weight on a stand. It's too loose. So I'll just use a crotch one. Because, like I said, the ball joint in the waist is extremely tight, so I think it would hold the weight of the dragon fangs, which I'm going to show right now. Because this is the drawing point, I think, to the supernova Altron. These freaking dragon fangs are amazing. Now, my one gripe with the way it looks is I wish these parts could fold to the side and go together like a normal Nataku. But that's as far down as they go. Maybe if I cut a little bit of a gap in here, I could bring it down. But as it is, that's what they have to do to store. We got the two green colors, a nice gold. I do have these little movable fins. And I love how this thing opens. It's got the big ball joint. Like, those are big ball joints. They can come up on a hinge. And then you have these ones, which are ball jointed and have a double hinge. Or, sorry, just the one hinge. They can come out. They'll have red teeth. And then you have a mouth here. That looks like the Predator. And I love it. I love it. Very cool looking. Now, all these are ball jointed. You'll see they're not moving. They're very stiff. But even being so stiff, they're still a little loose. If you don't put them in exactly the right pose, they will droop under the weight of the dragon fang. But these are all very tight. Very hard. They hurt my fingers because I had to put, you had to do it 20 times. 10 for each arm. And they're very tight. They are very secure. Nice, thick, bellable, was it dumbbell ball joints? So, to connect these to the Ultron, there is a connection point in the backpack, which you just have to unplug these little panels here, which are very secure. And there that goes. I'm never gonna find these parts again, am I? Oh well. So, you just, they're in a certain, like a key shape. Plug them in. And there it is. Not a super, I don't feel it's super tight. I wish it was a little tighter there. Probably fix up with some floor polish or whatever. But there it is. There is the dragon fang. Like I said, if you get it in a certain position, you can get them to hold their shape. But you can see it in time. You go into your room and just they'll be down on the ground. But they do try and hold their. It is very tight. Everything is ball jointed and can all move wherever you want. So you can get some pretty nice poses, I think. Now, the other cool thing is, if you don't want to use them, like in the air, you can. Let me catch the other one. Just put that one in there. There is the connector in the arm, which is on a hinge and also extends. Oops, but you can plug it into the arm. Oops, there was that skirt piece. I knew that was gonna happen at least once. Yeah. Just have to kind of maneuver the red arm piece, and then just hook it to the arm. I was just there, you can kind of get that connection point here. I was just holding it so it doesn't, because it's plugged into two connections inside the head, and if you push it from the head, it'll separate and then be loose. So I was just trying to do it from in here, which can be a little difficult. Okay, it can be very difficult, but it is a tight connection once you get it plugged in. Like that. And then you can just kind of arrange the red pieces however you want to get them in the back. And there they are attached. And they will move with the arm because they got so many joints. And this part, and this is another thing. Once these come off, you have to take the entire skirt off because the ball joint just gets in the way. So these, I would definitely suggest gluing if you get it. Because there's a bit of a pain. And let me get this back together in here. There we go. And then do the same thing on this arm. Just, like I said, get everything compressed. And then try and connect it to the arm. This arm here comes off at the shoulder joint much more than the other one. And there we go. Now with these connected to the back, I find that the leg extension problem kind of goes away. Because those dragon fangs are so freaking big that he looks kind of proportioned now, don't you think? I think so. And if you find that the ball joints aren't holding as well as you like, you do get a little stay. I get two of these with a super long rod. I would suggest cutting them in half because that's way too long. But there is a port right in here in the dragon fang, which you do have to kind of wedge it in, but it will connect, and then you can have them standing, like, hovering on the stand if you want. But as of right now, as I said, they can be positioned in the air and float there without a problem. You just have to kind of get the ball joints at a certain angle so they don't droop. And that is pretty much it for the Ultron Gundam. So, gonna do some comparisons. Let's work with another third-party kit. Because, like I said, I think this is Supernova's first attempt, which is a fairly good attempt. But here he is with the Dragon Momoko Strike Noir, which is also taller than the original because he has leg extensions in the thighs. They're about the same height, I'd say. And, come on, I don't get a lot of parts, get out of the way. And then my version of the Nataku, using the original Shenlong Bandai version. And yeah, he is definitely short. Those legs definitely, and the waist, and I think the stomach extensions give him quite a bit of height. Now, another good thing, if you're like, well, I love the Dragon Fangs, but I don't like the Shenlong, the Ultron body, the backpack for the Ultron will totally fit on the Shenlong, if you already have the Shenlong, so you can swap. If you want to have these kind of dragon fangs on the Bandai, it totally works, without a problem. And since the arms, I think, are the same too, the connection ports are the same, I have actually tried it, but I don't see why they wouldn't fit on the arms either. So that is Supernova's Ultron. I love this thing. There are some problems, like I said. I like that it's taller, but I'm not really a big fan of segmented armor pieces. They're alright, but I don't know. I don't know how I feel about it. I wish the head wasn't so, didn't have such a long neck. That annoys me. Like I said, some of the parts fall off. That's okay. You can glue that. You can fix that. It's not a big deal. The dragon fangs are spectacular. Like, all these thick ball joints that do really work well and can support the way of the dragon fangs if you mess with it enough. I think it's pretty awesome. And it doesn't need those extra stickers. I don't think it does. Like, this hasn't got any stickers on it at all. And just all that extra detail really does make this thing look different. So if you want to pick it up, click the link below to go to Gundam Central, and I'll see you in the next review.